Welcome back to Sovereign Actual. This week, the review will be a little different. I decided to make a special edition episode, an early access review. Let's start with the game is, and as you can see, it's Escape from Tarkov, made by Battlestate Games. And this is a fairly popular game among streamers, and I myself was introduced to it via a streamer and YouTuber named Operator Drewski. Escape from Tarkov can be considered as hardcore milsim, though technically the military aspect is missing. Let's get into playing it. Just some fair warning, I am absolute trash at this game, and as I go through here, I will cover some basic categories. First off, we'll go over the visuals. When it comes to game design, visuals are the most central part of that. It's the part that players see, it's the part that people familiarize themselves with. There are the game mechanics, but that's always second to visuals. Visuals are what a lot of people base games upon. So we'll start with that. Tarkov is map-based, and the maps are extremely detailed and at times hyper-realistic. For example, the mall on Interchange feels like every massive mall I've ever visited. It's awesomely immersive. The maps themselves do feel lived in, and they feel very real world. They also have a nice diversity, ranging from, well, the large shopping mall, to a military train yard, to a national park, and so on, with more maps yet to be released. The textures are good, great even. At times the trees can look plastic, but that's mostly dependent on the lighting, and the weapon textures are top notch. Inspecting the weapons in games feels more like you're sitting there looking at the real thing. The only thing you're lacking is the weight of it in your hands. I didn't notice any issues with the seams between textures or overly redundant textures. Everything feels very well put together. But when we really get into this, I have to talk about the animations. Something I don't normally bring up. And the animations here are decently worked out. And considering this game just entered its beta phase, the characters actually are very well worked out. They move smoothly. The gun works as it should. The only real issue is if you walk past something too close with your gun out in front of you, your gun goes sideways on the screen. I understand the reason for this. It's a complaint I always had with, like, Halo. As you walk through, the barrel of your gun will technically be on the other side of a wall, for example. This negates that. But the animation, it snaps. It's very robotic. It's not a fluid movement. It doesn't feel like the way a human would suddenly move the gun off to the left like it does in the game. The audio in Tarkov is phenomenal, and in no small part because they worked very hard to make it that way. Sounds in-game are more important than visuals, sometimes anyway, and walking across different surfaces makes different sounds and can reveal your location to players that know the map enough to know where those sounds can be made in relation to where they are. There's also in-game headsets that amplify sounds in various ranges to help you hear further and pick up quieter sounds. The controls are fairly standard. I mean, if you play a first-person shooter on the PC, such as Squad or Call of Duty, then the controls here won't give you much trouble. They work perfectly fine for what the game is. The user interface is limited. And again, that's something Battlestate Games did by design. There's no reticle unless you have sights that have them. There's no magic ammo count. You have to pull the magazine out and determine that for yourself. You can see your health in the inventory menus, but you can't see what direction you were shot from. There's no hit markers. It's very... To determine where you're shot from, you have to listen. And sometimes on, like, the first shot at you, you can't determine where it originated unless there's multiple shots. Difficulty can be broken down into really four things, which are the different enemies. Player scavs are players that spawn in with random character with random gear, and their goal is the same as yours: kill people, take their stuff, and reach the exfiltration. They are less of a threat than PMCs, but more of a threat than AI scavs, which do the same thing. You can play as a player scav, obviously, it's right there in the title. When you play as a scav, it doesn't negatively affect your main character's progression. AI scavs, like the player version, they kill and loot, but they also stand around needlessly at times. They do react to and investigate sounds and gunshots, and they can overwhelm you if they have partners. They're also not too bad at shooting. The AI scav bosses, well, they're much tougher. They usually have better gear, like Killa and Interchange, but they can also have a squad of scavs as bodyguards, which can make taking them out as a solo player a challenge. But in Tarkov, the PMCs are the real enemy and challenge of the game, and they are the ones that are most likely going to kill you. Some PMCs, like myself, are terrible. Some, though, are very skilled at the game and can easily wipe you out and cause you to lose all your loot and any uninsured gear you went into the raid with. This is where the main challenge comes from, is your whole point is to survive. Get as much stuff as you can and leave the map in one piece. If you die, you lose all that. That's the challenge of Tarkov. The history, the lore, the story behind Tarkov, I had to Google it. I didn't know what it was. The game didn't really explain that to me. It could be explained as simply because it's still in beta and they wanted to get the gameplay ironed out before they ironed out their story or any cinematics. Perhaps not. The story behind Tarkov is simple. The once large and prosperous city has fallen into anarchy and chaos after the contract wars, and is now populated with scavengers and sketchy military folks such as yourself. Tarkov is a PvPvE game. There are AI enemies, you have AI scavs and scav bosses, simple human AIs that are a good shot but not the best at hiding, and there are also player scavs which spawn in with random gear. The main enemy are the PMCs, which I said before, players with better gear and equipment. They are the enemy you really want to go for, and they are all humans behind a mouse and keyboard somewhere. The AI scavs aren't as much of a challenge as the players, so it's mostly PvP. Now, this is a short video. I don't have good footage. My capture card was being a pain in the neck. OBS was glitching out, so this is a short one. So we'll go into the score. Even though this game is in beta, it seems to be rather popular and well thought out. I'll give it a score of 9 out of 10, and I'll stand behind that. I think as more maps and content are released and the game becomes more well known, it could possibly even reach that score of 10 out of 10. Escape from Tarkov is a well-delivered raid-based PvP game that shockingly doesn't subscribe to that battle royale bandwagon that every other game company seems to be jumping on. It's a fun game, it's a challenging game, and it's better with friends. I recommend that, if you are able and you enjoy this style game, you give it a chance. And on that note, we're finished. Thank you for watching. Feel free to like or subscribe or don't, you know, whatever. And please come back anytime. I do hope that my videos will get better. This one is subpar. I apologize for that. Life is hectic, as you know, with the pandemic, and I've got some work things going on, and it's just crazy. But I plan to at least get one video out a week until things settle down, and I'm going to try to pick it back up. So please, stop in, and let's see where things go. I also stream every Saturday. Well, I try to. I missed last Saturday, and I apologize for that. I might miss it today, too. I've just got a lot going on. With that, I'll see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.